Supermodel Niki Taylor, she's much more than a pretty face. You know, an accident 12 years ago changed her world. It changed everything that she took for granted. But today she's living proof that simple acts of kindness can save a life. The world first met supermodel Niki Taylor when she was just a kid. She began modeling at age 14 and has graced the cover of more than 300 magazines. But this story isn't just about international stardom. Taylor is proof that life can change in an instant.
The car's involved, sir.
A night out with friends.
It's a telephone pole.
Taylor was riding in the passenger seat.
Niki Taylor was involved in a single car accident.
Her spine was fractured.
Miss Taylor suffered severe internal injuries.
Her liver torn in half. Her heart stopped beating on the operating table twice, and she lost nearly 80% of her blood. In less than 24 hours, Taylor received more than 100 life-saving blood transfusions. Despite months in the ICU and being given a 1 in 10 chance of survival, Taylor beat the odds. And every day, this mother of four says she thinks about those blood donors who rolled up their sleeves.
Thank you.
To give her a second chance at life.
You know, it's incredible to watch that, and obviously to see you here in person looking so healthy, so obviously alive. It's 12 years ago now.
Yes.
Does it feel like 12 years ago?
It does feel, and I'm glad that I'm on this side of it. Let's just put it.
Are you feeling well? I mean, do you have any lingering sort of effects from all that?
Nothing. Amazing.
Pain, anything?
No pain.
So 3 months or so in the hospital. And because of infection precautions, I mean, you couldn't see your sons. They were 6 years old at the time, is that right?
So I guess they don't let anybody under 10 in the ICU unit. So it was 3 months. But my mom was so amazing. My mom's a photographer. She brought me, they put pictures because I, had a trach. I had tubes in my lungs and coming out of me, so I couldn't really move. But they had put pictures on my ceiling of them.
When you finally did, you went to a rehab facility and then eventually were allowed to leave. I mean, was there something that surprised you in terms of the challenges after that? Was it more emotional, more physical?
I was amazed how the body heals itself. Yeah. I mean, for the liver to regenerate itself. So I learned a lot and educated myself a lot. The human body is just amazing. But if it weren't for the blood, I wouldn't be here. If it weren't for those donors, I wouldn't be here.
100 blood transfusions.
Over 100 units.
300 different donors, is my understanding as well.
Yeah.
That's part of the reason you're back now.
That is.
What do you say to people? I mean, because literally, they gave you a chance at life.
Yeah, I can't wait to hug them and kiss them and just look in their eyes, because I've always wanted to know what their personalities were like too. But I'm serious. I pray for them and I think about them a lot.
How big a problem is, enough people aren't donating blood. What is the shortfall?
Well, I just don't think people are thinking about it. I know World Blood Donor Day is in June, and it's the summer, so people's schedules are very busy, and they're just not thinking about going up and giving blood. But it's also a generational thing. My mom is part of the Gallon Club, and my dad and their parents before. It's almost like it's missed a generation, and I think we need to talk about it more. We need to make it a family group thing. And there's a lot of people that need blood transfusions. Cancer patients, and again, like I said, you just never know when your life can change in a matter of minutes, even seconds. You're going to need blood.
It's interesting because I think that the numbers, as you point out, they do seem to have dropped off in terms of people giving blood. So they get to see you now. They know you. They see you on television now, doing well, not in pain, healthy. So what do you say to people out there who are teetering on the edge, thought about it, but never done it?
I think most people are just scared. They're like, oh, that's a needle. You guys are taking blood from me. And it's not scary at all. It is just a pinch. And I have been on, a dozen blood drives, and it doesn't hurt at all. You have the best technicians, and they will find a vein, and you get cookies and milk, and they just make you super comfortable. They'll bring you a warm blanket. But it's very comfortable, and it's very easy to do.
They're really good, too, as you point out, at getting those needles, and it's not easy.
No.
100 transfusions, again, a lot. I'm so glad you're doing well. It's such a good thing, too, to thank those donors.
Oh, it is.
I think it's going to do a lot to keep donations up in this country.
Yeah,
thanks for joining us.
I can't wait.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.